Welcome to all of you. Today's session are causal and non-causal signals. In the previous discussion, we discussed about the different kinds of signals based on the properties, that is nothing but periodic and aperiodic signal. And the second classification is nothing but energy and power signal. Now, we are going to discuss about third classification, that is nothing but causal and non-causal signals. Causal So this is nothing but causal and non-causal signal. Suppose x of n is a discrete time signal. Okay, if x of n is a discrete time signal, the signal x of n is said to be a causal signal if its value, if x of n value is zero for n less than zero. Okay. That signal is generally called as a causal signal. If x of n value is zero for non-zero for or else we can also say like this, if x of n value is zero for n less than zero, then the signal is causal signal. Otherwise it is a non-causal signal. The example for causal signal is equal to x of n is equal to u of n. It is a causal signal because it starts from zero onwards. N is equal to zero. 3, 4, 5, 9. It is a causal signal because it starts from n is equal to 0 to infinity. But for negative values, n less than values, this value is equal to 0. Therefore, which satisfies the above condition, therefore the given signal x of n is a causal signal. Suppose if we consider x of n is equal to something like this. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. It is a given sequence. Let us consider here. Here arrow indicates that spawning point, that means we will consider it as a 0. 0 is the first position, it is the second position, minus 1, minus 1. That means in this x of n sequence, for n less than 0 values also, the value is existing. Therefore, these kind of signals are generally called as a non-causal signals. Okay. For x of n is equal to 0 for n less than condition, the corresponding signals are generally called as a causal signals. If x of n is equal to some value for n less than 0 also, those kind of signals are generally called as a non-causal signal. So this is just a brief introduction about the causal and non-causal signal. In the next classification is nothing but even and odd signals. For the last classification, the classification is nothing but even and odd signals. Okay. So here, let us consider x of n is a discrete time signal. Okay, here also x of n is a discrete. Why? Because I am only interested on the discrete time domain. That's why we consider x of n. If you are interested in the continuous time, we will go for next analysis. That is nothing but x of t. Okay, that is also already discussed in the signals and systems concepts. But we are discussing only on the distance signal processing domain. So for that purpose, we will consider each and every in the x of n is the discrete time domain. Therefore, x of n is a discrete time signal. Discrete time signal or sequence, both are same. Discrete time signal. If x of n is a even, if x of n is said to be even signal, if it satisfies x of minus n is equal to x of n, then x of n sequence is, which is even condition. Okay, it is the even signal condition. If x of n is said to be odd signal, if it satisfies x of minus n is equal to minus x of n, right? The signal x of n satisfies this condition, then it is an even signal. If x of n satisfies this condition, then it is a odd signal. So based on the corresponding condition, the given sequence is an even signal or given sequence is an odd signal. Generally, x of n is a sequence. The x of n sequence can be represented as sum of even and odd numbers. Therefore, x of n plus x naught of n. Just replace n by minus n. Therefore, x of minus n is equal to x of n plus x naught of minus n. Okay. Now, based on the corresponding properties, even and odd properties, it can be represented as x of minus n is equal to x e of n. It is a minus n actually. X e of minus n is equal to x of n because of it is an even signal condition. For x naught of minus n is equal to minus n, therefore minus x of n. Let us consider equation number 2. Let us consider equation number 1. Now, by adding equation number 1 and equation number 2, we can get x of n plus x of minus n is equal to 2 into x e of n. Therefore, x e of n is equal to 1 by 2 of x of n minus x of minus n plus x of minus n. So, this is the condition for even signal. Second one is nothing but by subtracting, subtracting equation 1 and equation number 2 here, by adding 1 and 2, we will get the even component. By subtracting equation number 1 and equation number 2, we can get the odd component. Therefore, x naught of n is equal to 1 by 2 times of x of n minus x of n. This is a condition for even component and odd component. Suppose in the real time scenario, in the real time example, if x of n is a given sequence, check whether find the even and odd components of the corresponding sequence. We have to use these two problems. That is nothing but x of n, for if you want to calculate the x of n, 1 by 2 x of n plus x of minus. X of minus means that it's a Fourier version. And if you want to calculate the odd component of the corresponding sequence, x naught of n is equal to 1 by 2 x of n minus of x of minus. X of minus means reverse are folded of the corresponding. If you are subtracting those divided by 2, we can get the odd component. By adding those and divided by 2, we can get the even component. So this is just a brief introduction about the classification of signals in the class. Just this is a summary for four classification. What are the based on the properties of signals? We have four types of signals. That is nothing but even signal, that is nothing but periodic and aperiodic signal. Second one is nothing but energy and power signal. And third one is nothing but causal and non-causal. And fourth one is nothing but even and odd components. So what is the general definition for periodic and aperiodic? If x of n satisfies the periodic condition, it is a periodic signal. If x of n does not satisfy the periodic condition, then it is generally called as an aperiodic signal. In the second classification, means that energy and power signal. If we are referring to two formulas for energy and power signal. If we get the energy is equal to some finite value and power is equal to some zero values, then we can say that the corresponding sequence is the energy signal. If energy is equal to infinite and power is equal to some finite value, then we can say that the corresponding signal is the power signal. In the third classification is nothing but causal and non-causal. For causal and non-causal sequence, x of n value is zero for n less than zero condition. The given sequence is generally called as a causal signal. If x of n is equal to maybe some value for n less than 0 also, those kind of signals are generally called as a non-causal signal. In the last classification, even under our components, x of n is a discrete time signal. The even condition for the corresponding one is equal to this one, x of minus n is equal to x of n. For our condition, x of minus n is equal to minus x of n. When the corresponding signal satisfies these two conditions, obviously it is a even or odd component. The general examples for even signal is equal to cos is an even signal. Okay, for odd condition, it is a sinusoidal. Okay, sine omega. Okay, so these are the two examples for even condition. This is the odd condition. We can also call as even signal is also called as symmetric. Okay, odd signal also called as anti-symmetric. These are the another names for the corresponding even and odd components. Okay. So with this, our classification of signals topic is over.